Welcome to the new Gaming Careers Studio. I will have a video going through everything new in the coming weeks, but today we're going to be talking about OBS Studio and a plugin that's come out in 2021 that I think a lot of you are going to really enjoy, especially those that like to push the limits of production value for your live streams. So what this new OBS plugin allows you to do is completely customize the transitions that are used depending on what scene you're transitioning from and what scene you're transitioning to. And I can see some of you rolling your eyes and saying, Pete, you already told us about transition override in your OBS advanced tips video. No, this is a whole new level of customization. Transition override only lets you set a custom transition to use when you switch to a specific scene, but it doesn't matter which scene you switch from. This plugin takes into account the scene you're transitioning from as well as the scene you're transitioning to, so you can completely customize your live stream. So as an example, let's say you want to show a stinger transition when you're going from a starting soon scene to your gameplay scene, but you want a different transition to show when you're going from a chatting scene to your gameplay scene. That is what this plugin allows you to do. It's super simple to set up and it's gonna help you stand out from all the competition with that next level of production. So let's dive in. Just before we get started, I would like to thank the sponsor of this video, Oslo.io. Oslo is a new software service built by the guys over at Streamlabs that helps you simplify your video production and collaboration process. Oslo allows you to easily upload and share video projects securely in the cloud, where you can get frame accurate comments on your videos and post directly to your YouTube channel. If you ever find yourself needing to collaborate on videos, I'd highly recommend checking out Oslo.io using the link in the video description. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is actually install the plugin into OBS Studio. So to do that, head to the link that I've included down in the description down below. It'll take you to this page here on the OBS website where we can see the plugin and actually download and install it. And we can see it's been developed by Exceldro, who's the same person behind the Move Transition plugin that I've covered in a couple of videos. But you want to come up to the link here where it says download. You have a few different options. You can use an installer if you don't know exactly where you've installed OBS Studio, or you can just drag across the plugins folders from a zip file as well. Once those files have finished installing, you'll need to relaunch OBS Studio if you already had it open. And if you come up to the tools menu here, you should see a new option here called transition table, which means that everything has installed successfully. Before we dive into the options of the transition table, let's have a look at actually the scene setup that I have here in OBS Studio. So I have four different scenes: the starting soon scene, an intermission scene, which has my webcam in it, the in-game scene, which is actually where I play my gameplay, and an ending scene when I am finished streaming. As you can see right now, as I swap between these scenes, it's just using a simple cut transition. So there's no fade, there's no stinger transition, it's just a simple cut no matter which scene I'm transitioning from or to. If I came over to the default OBS Studio options to change the scene transition and change this from, say, a cut to a fade with a duration of 500 milliseconds, now whenever I change between scenes, you can see it uses a fade transition over a duration of 500 milliseconds. So for the majority of people watching, you're probably using a stinger transition, something a little bit more advanced. So if I select my gaming careers stinger, you'll see now as I swap between scenes here, it will show my gaming careers stinger, and then the scene transition will happen in the background. But that happens no matter which scene I'm transitioning from or to. So what if I didn't actually want that? What if I only wanted to show this stinger transition when I was transitioning from the stream is starting soon scene, when this countdown timer, say, reaches zero? I wanted to then show the stinger transition and move to a different scene. But whenever I was transitioning between my in-game scene and my intermission scene whilst I was streaming, I didn't want the stinger to show every single time because it's quite lengthy. Well, that is where the transition table plugin comes in. So if we just go back to the scene transitions options here and change this back to the default cut, and then we can open up the transition table plugin here by clicking on this option in the tools menu. So as you can see here, we have no rules currently set up. So let's add our first rule on that example I just mentioned. So what I want to say here is whenever I'm swapping from my stream is starting soon scene to any other scene, so it doesn't matter which scene I'm transitioning to, I'm going to select any here, I want to use the Gaming Careers Stinger transition. And you don't need to worry about the duration when you're talking about stinger transitions, because you've already set that up when you added the stinger transition. So then all we need to do is click set, and if we close this down, you can see now it's added an option to the table. But if we close this down, you'll see no matter where we transition from this starting soon scene to, it's always going to use the stinger transition. But if we go from, say, in-game to intermission, it's just going to use a cut, or intermission back to starting is going to use a cut. So it's always using the stinger transition when we're going from our starting soon scene to any other scene. So let's add a second rule to the transition table plugin, come back into the options, and our second rule is going to be if we're going from our intermission to our game scene, we want to be using the actual transition that came included in this graphic pack from Nerd or Die, which is the cybernetic stinger. And again, we don't need to worry about the duration because it's a stinger. We can click set. And whilst we're here, let's just do the opposite. So if we're going from in-game to our intermission, again, we want to use the cybernetic stinger. So click set there as well. So if we close that down now, you'll see that if we go back to our starting soon scene, it just cuts because we have no rule about going to that scene. If we go from starting to say intermission, it should use a stinger. And then if we go from intermission to in-game, it's going to use the stinger that was included in this pack. And if we go from in-game to intermission, it'll use the same stinger. So everything is working exactly as we wanted. Let's add a final rule to the transition table plugin. So the final one that I'm going to do is when I'm finishing my stream, I want to have a transition when I'm going from any scene to my ending scene. So it doesn't matter which scene I'm transitioning from. If I'm going to my ending scene, I want to use the Luma wipe transition over a duration of 500 milliseconds. And you can change this because Luma wipe is one of the ones where you can actually change the duration here. So let's say we want to go to 700 milliseconds and then click set. And that means that no matter which scene I'm on, if I go to my ending scene, it's going to use that Luma wipe transition. So in terms of the actual plugin controls, that's pretty much it. Really, the creativity and control is completely down to you as to how you use this. But I will give a few tips just from using the plugin over the past week or so. So if we open it up, one thing I will say is make use of the any option here to save yourself from adding like 5 or 6 different rules. If you're wanting to apply a rule to transition to a scene or from a scene, and it's always going to be standard, then make sure you use the any rule here. Also worth noting that if you ever want to delete any rules, you can select as many as you want down here on the right hand side and then come to here to delete them if you do want to remove them. If you have a really complex OBS Studio setup and you have, you know, dozens of rules that you've written into this table, it can be useful to filter them if you want to see or remove a certain one. So you can use these as sort of filters if you want to see all the scenes, all the transitions that are transitioning from your starting soon scene. You can just select that here and then it'll show all the rules down below in the table. One thing to note is it's really important, I think, to have your scenes named properly. There's nothing more confusing than opening up the transition table plugin to see scenes named scene 1, scene 2, scene 2 copy, and then trying to work out which scene is actually which. So name your scenes properly, use labels like game, starting, ending, like I have, and it makes this whole process a lot easier. Finally, just get creative with it. Make some really cool stinger transitions and you're no longer limited by having to think of stinger transitions that will apply to your whole stream because you can apply each stinger transition uniquely. So get really creative of how you're going to transition from your intermission scene to your game scene or to your just chatting or to your be right back. You can really afford to get creative in programs like Adobe After Effects. And of course, I do have a video about building a stinger transition if you are interested in learning how to do that. Thanks so much for watching the video. If you have enjoyed it, please do give it a thumbs up. That helps us know what kind of content you guys enjoy. And if you haven't yet checked out the Gaming Careers podcast, I'd highly recommend doing so. It's a show that I do weekly with Ben Green. And we have a video version and an audio version. So if you're an audio podcast listener, just search Gaming Careers podcast on any app of choice. And if you're a video watcher, you want to see mine and Ben's faces, we do have a separate YouTube channel called Gaming Careers Podcast, which I'll leave linked down in the description. Catch you in the next one. Peace.
Yeah, Greffy just sort of carried the last quarter with this single day stream, just inflating all the numbers. That'd be pretty interesting.
Jeff Bezos like giving Twitch more money to invest because they're seeing these crazy growth numbers, but it's really literally down to one guy and his Fortnite skin.